Yeah, they just like daisy chaining. Maybe they're getting ready for a little Jack orgy or something. They're really sensitive. You gotta get really close. Most of the time, Jacks are crazy. I think these are in a spawning round or something.
Yeah, look how they're like laid up.
Yeah, they kind of laid up, Jack.
Concerned with what they're doing.
Yeah. There you go. Let's look at it. You're in the zone there. You're in the zone right there. Man, look at them there. Come on, hit.
They just hit.
They just have their minds on something else. Oh,
look at them.
They've got their minds on something else.
I have a popper. Turning off.
So one's gotta get it.
Beautiful jacks, too. Gotta change fly.
Yeah, they think they're like
I'm changing fly.
Dave switched flies to a red and white half and half on a one-aught hook. You can also fish with a plowser minnow, blue and white, on a one-aught hook. Works very good too. For stripping, first cast and strip slowly to get the fish's attention. And once you get the fish's attention, then start stripping as fast as you can. And remember, use the strip strike before you start raising your rod.
They haven't felt us yet much. There you are, you're in the zone now. There's one, look at it. There's one, and they got it, finally, Jack. Get ready, because he's going to start taking off. Woo, look at them, follow them along. Look at all those Jacks. Here they goes. Off to the races, he'll clear that line pretty good. Sweet! Our breakfast in the morning.
We had to work for that, Jack.
Yeah. But we were right there at the right time last time. We came to let them drift right to us. Because, yeah, you drift towards, you push towards and pull towards, they feel that push, man, they shit right off.
They got that nice handle right at their tail.
Yeah.
Great.
But when they get bigger, man, if you don't have any gloves on, they got these big things that can cut you.
Where are they? Just above the tail.
Above the tail, around, I'll show you.
Oh, look at the baby cough duck.
Ah, yeah, there you go.
Yeah,
they're getting
them.
Yeah.
God, I may end up having you land him when we get closer.
Yeah.
Yeah,
he'll be dogging.
He's growing a little bit when you get him closer to the camp.
Yeah.
On the edge of his mouth. Damn, I wanted a picture.
For those jacks, we were actually fishing with an 8-weight fly rod with a forward weight floating fly line. For the larger jacks, you might have to go with something larger like a 10-weight to give you a little more power to fight those jacks. Here's a tip on how you could approach a school of daisy chain fish and not get them all nervous and upset. There's two reasons why these fishes are actually in a daisy chain. One reason, this is a defensive mode to protect themselves from other fishes, you know, trying to attack them. They actually have their eyes and their sensory results all outside, and they could actually sense when something dangerous is coming towards them. Another reason is that they are out there in a mating or in a spawning situation, and they're just out there having a good time. But they are not in a feeding mode. The main thing you could do is you get your little flats boat, like Darth Vader. I see your tarpon is as big as mine. But anyway, so what you want to do is, your main thing you want to do is find your wind direction. This is the key to approach those schools of daisy chain fish. So if the wind direction, the wind direction is going on that way, you want to go upwind to the school of daisy chain and slowly drift, and let the wind drift you towards the school where you could get into casting range. But if you try to run your boat straight towards it or try to pull into it, they'll actually sense your boat and take off and leave. So if that wind direction is this way, then you could, you know, actually go upwind and slowly drift this way. If the wind direction is this way, you go upwind and then slowly drift towards them. The main thing is go upwind to the school of daisy chaining fish and slowly drift towards them, then they won't sense you. Give that a try. There's one chasing it already. He's chasing it. Bring it in and shoot it again. Right there.
A little short again.
He's chasing it. He's chasing it. Oh, man. There you go.
Little window again, I think.
I guess that's how fast they want it. I got the take. I guess that's how fast they want it.
Yeah, they
as fast as you're pulling it in the in the boat.
Look at them in there. Ooh, there's a couple big ones in there.
Ooh, move. Now he's going with the group. That little thing for the rod, pop it there. Pop this. Can't this. If you're busy. Okay, I got it. Thank you, Jer.
Woo! That's how it's done.
All right, we got a good picture for the shot, which I love, for the photo album.